Now, CGTN's original series Tech It Out is ready with its second season. On Global Watch this week, we will show you the scientific and technological breakthroughs and ideas in China that will reshape our world. Today, we look at a serious global disease, depression. It affects hundreds of millions globally. A recent case was death of Stanford University physicist Zhang Shoucheng. So what causes depression and what can we do about it? Scientists now might have some clue.
有些人告诉你好像掉到深渊里去，他无助感、无望感就变得非常的强烈。
Around the world, 300 million people struggle with major depression, but 30 to 50% of them don't get any better on antidepressants.
所有的抗抑郁药到现在为止，它都是两周才可以起效，但是要等时间让它起效果，在这个过程中很多人就会进行自杀。2000年的时候有一篇文章，它是报道了氯胺酮是就是三天，更多的报道发现了它两个小时就是非常有效了。
Ketamine is a widely used anesthetic, but is perhaps most commonly known as the club drug Special K. But in recent years, it has become many clinicians' best hope for curing depression. In some cases, a low dose infusion can offer complete relief.
现在讲我们用氯胺酮来治疗抑郁症是你要持续的使用的话它就可能成瘾。
Scientists still have very limited knowledge on how ketamine works. Currently, no government on the planet has approved ketamine treatment.
我是胡海兰，我是一名脑科学家，我和我的团队一直在大脑当中试图寻找抑郁症的成因。
Years of research has narrowed down scientists' focus. They now zone in on a small area in the central brain that possesses bad moods, the lateral habenula. Inside a lateral habenula in good running order, neurons transfer unpleasant moods to other parts of brain at a controllable speed by firing at spaced intervals. But in a depressive brain,Scientists see a different scenario. Erratic bursts of electrical impulses. Is that just a coincidence? To prove their theory, the team provoked the neurons in the habenula into firing and bursts using optogenetics, a pioneer technology that allows neurons to be activated with light.
如果我们能够用光的手段来诱发这样的粗壮放电，然后看见了这个行为，这样我们就可以建立行为和放电之间的因果关系。
This experiment is going to unlock the secret of depression. Just watch. In just a short time, this little rat has shown increased depressive behavior. Unlike its untreated companion who instinctively struggles when forced to swim, this one chooses to give up.
外侧浆核在抑郁症的时候会产生异常的粗壮放电，和普通的放电相比，就好像是机关枪扫射，能够更有效地将负面情绪相关的信息传导到下游的脑区。
Anything that can block the firing and get the habenula operating as normal would eventually alleviate depression. Scientists think ketamine might fit the bill.
之前的研究，大家一般是将氯胺酮通过外周的注射，通过血液来进入到脑中，它产生的是一个全脑的影响，所以我们很难知道它究竟在哪个脑区当中发挥关键的作用。在我们这个工作当中，我们就选择将氯胺酮局部的注射到外侧浆核这样一个脑区当中，结果我们就很惊喜地发现，在几秒钟之内就阻断了外侧浆核的粗壮放电，在一个小时之内就改善了动物的类似于抑郁的表型。
Unlike the conventional antidepressant, which aim to improve your pleasant mood, Ketamine does the opposite by blocking your unpleasant feelings. Understanding why ketamine acts so quickly will provide us the greater insight into the core mechanism of depression and help us to develop ketamine alternative that does not have the same side effect as the drug itself.
我们收到很多来自于临床的病人和医生的来信，有一些患者的来信中就说他们会感觉到没有被世界放弃，因为看到还有很多人正在为攻克这个疾病进行努力，也有更多的未解之谜在等待着我们。